Hey everybody, I'm here just gonna do another adventure run and do some pulls after. As you can see, I got my 80th traveler today, Cyrus. So we're gonna attempt to do some adventure with Cyrus in the party in the place of Glossom's equipment. We are gonna go ahead and steal Glossom's body armor. We're gonna use the chomper vest. So let me just find that real quick. Sorry, Varkin, you have lost your, sorry, Glossom, you have lost your spot. I am going to leave Cyrus with this energy belt. I am going to hope that he has enough SP to get through this fight. And in order to guarantee that, I'm going to change one of these skills to the single target. That way, if necessary, I can use that and still have something to do. He's unfortunately only level 90. I did get the BP to blast through hunts. He does have the Adamantine Tome 4, so that's nice. Just making sure all the other skills are in order. This is why we check our skills, because we don't want to end up with a fucking crash for no reason. Here we go. This is adventure part 3 or 4, depending on how many of these you've watched. This time with a new edition of Cyrus. So we will be Cyrus Gaming. We will go ahead and continue the normal strategy that I do enjoy using. So we'll have the boring fight. We're going to see if Cyrus can help reduce the time that this fight takes. Yikes, that still hurts. We got the good RNG there. So that's good. No worries here. Still gonna AOE. Still gonna AOE. Well, I guess it's just full bore. We're just gonna go with that. Wanna make sure puppy dog goes away. Here. Guess technically that would be better. I want to make sure that the pup dies. So I'm just going to guarantee that with the 3 hit from. I guess I didn't need to. I could have just done a single target there with Cyrus, but later on that's going to come in handy. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. I like it. We are going to continue in the same fashion. I always do the fight. We are simply trying to see how much Cyrus makes a difference in terms of turns with my methodology. There are better strategies out there. It's just a brain dead strategy that I happen to like. I think it's cool. It works. I'm going to continue to do it. You know, there's a couple other strategies out there that involve leaving them at one shield, killing them together. It's kind of cool to see that in action. So I definitely recommend you take a look out there. In this case, I am absolutely unequivocally trying to make sure save some time. All right. Just as for those of you who haven't watched before, the whole strategy here is very simple. Therion is there for a 6 hit. You want Viola to get at minimum 3 hits. Same for Fjord there. And then, of course, we use Varkin even though he's slower because he pairs well with Odette and amps up that damage, keeps the shred on, and generally just has a 3 hit, both random targets and single targets. And he has the AoE. And I use him and Millard to really pour on the damage. So, pretty straightforward. the AoE piece of the box goes down. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Millard is there for the AoE so that whether the fox covers or not, the fox is getting hit. It's just easy on the break turn because the whole point of the break turn is killing the fox. So that's what we're doing here. We're gonna go for the single target. Pretty sure the fox is gonna die well before that. May even get a double cast out of Odette. See if we get the streamer luck. Oh, look at that. And the 10% chance. So if not, Millard would have killed the fox there, but Millard does pretty good damage, as you can see there. It's not that good, but it's definitely good. Then we're gonna go back to this. As you can see, it is predicated on getting 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 17. It's gonna put him to 4. That doesn't have to happen every turn. The point is to get him to around 9. Oh my goodness. Okay, so that's a problem. That's a problem. Did not anticipate that happening. So Cyrus's speed is an issue. I'm gonna have to get him some HP. So I'm gonna have to put the Twilight Tome on him. I'm gonna have to get him a Twilight Tome. So that was a concern I had. I'm gonna see if I can finish this fight out. I don't know. Viola's not the most. Yeah, this could be bad, but I think I'm gonna try to finish it. And Blossom having a little bit more HP because he has the Twilight Fan. And he has the defense move there. That's unfortunate. Yeah. I'm probably going to run out of SP with Viola. It's going to be the biggest problem with this fight. I may just have to crash out, try again, and we'll call it a fail, just based on that, but really wanted to, this is rough, but we're going to try it. No need to give up yet. I'm not a quitter. I love it when Theo eats a lot of damage because he has the most HP because he's A4. And Millard's right behind him because he's A3. I know A4 and A3 have the same, just being technical there. But you know, it's okay. I think this is fine ultimately. I'm going to hope. I don't run out of SP with Viola, but I think it's inevitable at this point. I do use attacks with her quite a bit. In this case, it is just going to be a regular attack to save some SP. This does need to be an esoteric cure. I can't afford for Viola to bite the dust here. It should be enough. Oh my. That is dreadful. Okay, well, guess that'll save SP. Alright, not exactly what I had in mind. But that's alright. We can bring some allies here. For that reason, I think they're going to come in to be pretty valuable considering the SP problems that I may have in this fight. I think we'll be all right overall. Okay. No, I don't really need to do that. Six, seven. No, I am gonna. No. Let's do two attacks. It's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, that looks good. Just as long as the math is right. We can just adjust on the fly. It's unfortunate that Larkin ate it pretty hard there. Really not well. Again, we're just adjusting on the fly. How did that coming through in the clutch? Because I don't think the Fox was gonna die there. Otherwise. The nice thing is this turn is gonna be quite a bunch of, that's a lot of shields that are going down. Very nice. Here. Actually don't even want to do that. Yeah. It was tempting to go a different route. Get a little bit more guaranteed damage in, but not necessary right now. Regardless of whether this kills the fox. Yeah, I just really want to conserve SP for a little bit longer. I'm willing to use an ally. I'm going to be dead. Just really just clutching this. Oh, incredible. Just do a seven person clear here. That's incredible. Considering all of the misfortune with the Cyrus death, this has gone much better than anticipated. Just so much better than I thought it would after that happened. But, you know, we'll take it. Now, I can't afford to respawn the adventurer this time, which I've done several times, including in a video that's, you know, showing off the clear. But, you know, we're not doing that today. We are not doing that today. Alright. Yeah. Pretty confident. Even if the fox doesn't die, you'll be okay. Alright. So that should have enough. We'll actually use a triple edge. We have plenty of SP now. So I think we can. I think we can survive for the rest of the fight on SP. I think we're through the rough spots now. So we will. Just play it through. This is what you call Viola gaming. Yep, it's just a little bit of Viola gaming. Orion, on the other hand, is running out of SP now. But we'll be able to give him a turn off in a second. Most likely. This is definitely a make sure the fox dies turn, because we need the setup for this next turn to be pretty clean, because we're at the point where I'm a breakaway from Mr. Adventurer being dead. Sorry, I'm a bit tired. I've been up quite a long time, quite a long day, blitzing through story and getting everything right so I can pull Cyrus. Got lucky and got him in 30 pulls. Got excited about this fight, decided to make a video, and of course, we are definitely focusing on the fox here. Minimal damage to the adventurer here to guarantee the kill on the break. We will be using that repeated aria from Mr. Varkin guarantees it, but we were paralyzing tooth here anyway. I am actually going to debilitate here, and we'll just run it just like that. And there you have it. A nice adventure clear. Hopefully the audio isn't too bad. 30 turns, so even with an early Cyrus death, we still got it in 30 turns. Hooray. And as promised, I'm going to do a little bit of some pulls here. I don't have any rubies, as you can see, but I do have a couple of these seals, so let's go ahead and see what we get from these six. Let's go. Hopefully we get some good luck. Third pull. We're having great luck. Carol. Not gonna lie, I forgot Carol existed. I don't think I've ever used Carol. I leveled her to 45. That's all I can tell you, other than she's at least A1. He's couldn't sorry okay. I did remember sorry. It's kind of a unique name, so it sticks out.
Going swimming. I love it.
Actually kind of expected, but no, I don't blame.
Okay. That is not the end of the world. That's decent.
Obviously you would hope for
bit better than a bunch of 3 stars and like one decent 4-star.
But, you know,
tis the nature of the game.
And Minnow. Well, you know, I'll take it. So Minnow, new setup, and
some garbage. Now, coup de grace, I have 2 veteran seals saved up. We're actually hoping for Xanta here, but let's see what we get. Therium would be super nice as well, but Xanta is the, well, Cardona would be amazing. Love that. Let's see what we get.
Let's watch the swirly swirls. We'd love to see those.
This is guaranteed, so no surprise, but we'd love to see it. Okay. Power. Okay. Eliza. I'll take it. I did not have Eliza. That's very cool. I love it. very cool. Very nice. I am excited. I'm excited about that. I will not review. Okay. And finally, let's see what the last hope holds. Xanta, Cardona, even Lionel would be very cool. Who do we have? Okay. Again. You know what? Okay. I'll take a Primrose Duke. I'll take a Primrose Duke. Would have preferred Therion if I were going to get a Duke, but Primrose definitely helps. I definitely need help in the department. So we are going to go ahead and go to feats, collect my rubies. They're going to accept for having my 81st traveler. Let's see here. Does that make sense? Sure, why not? I don't really know what to do with her. She's got too many skills. but that's cool. Definitely nice to have
another 5-star traveler. Take it. It's kind of cool. All right, well, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Have a good one.